Credit scoring has much to offer to microfinance institutions and smaller banks. It is a simple and powerful tool in reducing operational costs and loan losses. Moreover, it speeds up the loan request evaluation process, reducing costs and improving customer satisfaction. Who would not be interested? In this series of videos, we will discuss four simple credit scoring techniques. Expert approach. Bayesian scoring. Logistic regression. And the Altman Z score. Our goal is to demystify the mathematics and logic behind these models. We will explain in plain terms the underlying principles. Using simple Excel models, we show how to use these techniques in practice. Even smaller institutions without sophisticated IT systems can put in place these scoring techniques. This third video in our series covers logistic regression. In the first part of the video, we discuss the linear regression, and in the second part, the logistic regression. To understand what logistic regression, we will recap what regression analysis is about. In regression analysis, we are looking for the relationship between an input variable and an output variable. This type of analysis is widely used in modeling and forecasting and is useful in credit scoring. An example is helpful here. In our bank or microfinance institution, we know from experience that there is a relationship between the number of years a client has run his business and the probability of default. The longer an entrepreneur is in business, the lower the default rate. From data from our historical loan portfolio, we get the following probability of default data. It would be great if we could create a simple model that takes as an input the years in business and returns the default rate. With regression analysis, we can construct this model. We will use Excel to do this. We start with plotting a scatter chart in Excel with along the x-axis the input data, in our case the years, and along the y-axis the output, in our case the PD rates. In the graph, we clearly see that there is a relationship. We can draw a straight line through these data points. If we know the function behind this line, we have our model. We define straight lines with the following function, y equals ax plus b. The y is the variable that we try to find, in our case the PD rate. We do this with an input x, the years in business. The letter a represent the slope of our line, and b the intercept or constant. The intercept is the value where the line cuts through the y-axis. We can rewrite this general function as follows. PD rate equals a times years in business plus b. How to find this slope and intercept? Well, in Excel these two functions equals slope and equals intercept. For both functions we need to define two arrays, the known ease and the known excess. Pay attention here, the y is the output, so the PD rates. The x is the input, so the years. With the slope and intercept known, we complete the definition of our function. PD rate equals minus 0.01 times years in business plus 0.08. We can define this function in Excel and use this to add a column to our table. This third column contains the forecasted PD rates as calculated by our model. Now we have the actual PD rates and the forecasted or modeled PD rates. Looking at the graph, we see that our model in orange follows the real PD data in blue closely. Since the model is a straight line, we call this linear regression. Now we take this a step further and move to the logistic regression. The first concept we need to understand is the S-curve or logistic function. We use this S-curve to transform a continuous input to a binary output. In the graph we see the S-curve or logistic function. The x-axis shows a client's profits or losses. The further right on the horizontal axis, the higher the profit and the lower the probability of not defaulting. On the left side of the graph we see the losses. The higher the losses, the higher the probability that the client will default on his loan obligations. We notice that the S-curve has a steep slope between minus 2 and positive 2. As we move further to the left and to the right, the curve flattens. A nice feature of this S-curve is that it stays between the floor of 0% and the ceiling of 100%. This binary output helps us to classify an input in two classes, default or non-default. We do this by defining a threshold. We could, for instance, say that we classify clients below the 20% cutoff as non-defaulter, and above 20% as clients with a high default probability. We notice that we translated the continuous input of company results into a yes or no classification. Moreover, the S-curve gives you an indication of the confidence level. Intuitively, we understand that values close to 100% have a high default risk. Alternatively, if we get closer to the 0%, the default risk disappears. In the middle, we are not so sure of the effectiveness of our classification method. We could interpret the percentage as a confidence indicator that shows how strong our belief is in the classification. In its most simple form, the logistic function looks like this: f x equals 1 over 1 plus e to the power of minus x. We steer away from the math but still want to get some feel for behavior of this function. The numerator defines the ceiling of the output. We see that this is 1 or 100%. We also understand that if the denominator takes on high values, the function approaches zero. The e in the function is Euler's number, a mathematical constant. This e constant equals 2.72. This constant is crucial in growth rate computations. In finance, Euler's number drives continuous interest calculations. In Excel, you can find Euler's number with the exponent function equals exp. You fill in 1 and will get 2.72. Lastly, the x in this function is our input variable that we use to calculate the output y. Now that we have some intuition of the formula, we are going to replace the x with a linear function that includes a series of categorical data. Categorical means that the data can only have certain values that put them in groups. Categorical data cannot be summed. For example, we can look at the industrial sector of the client. This client either belongs to the category agriculture, or cattle farm, or commerce, and so on. Next to the use of categorical data, we also seek to predict the Y using multiple input variables. This way we can consider, for instance, sector, gender, age, family situation, etc. We call this multilinear regression. We notice that again we have a linear function that includes coefficients and a constant. For each of the categorical values there is a coefficient. In the table we see that for agriculture the slope is minus 0.22. We notice that in the case of a multilinear regression function there are only slopes or coefficients, so there is no x in the formula. For a 28-year-old male entrepreneur, bachelor, working in agriculture, the formula would look like. So, the result of this multilinear function is minus 4.08. We need to put this in the general regression formula. Here we go. Our logistic regression model calculates that the probability of default for a 28-year-old male entrepreneur, bachelor, working in agriculture equals 1.66%. We can play with the inputs and get PDs for different clients. We can see how this model is useful for smaller banks and microfinance institutions. In our explanation, we have skipped the question where we got the coefficients for the categorical data. These coefficients can be derived from the historical loan data. The input is a data set of at least 1,000 clients. For these records, we now know the gender, age, sector, family situation, and most of all, whether they reimbursed the loan. Using a dummy variable technique and optimization with, for instance, Excel Solver, we can find these coefficients. This explanation is beyond the scope of this introductory video. It is important, however, to emphasize that this analysis can be done using Excel. So, no expensive or sophisticated software and consultants. Logistic regression scoring is a powerful tool in banking and microfinance. It works best for larger datasets. In practice, this means large volume, low monetary value loans. The nice thing about this approach is that it makes use of the financial institution's own data. The scoring rules are derived from the bank's specific data set, and the model is hence made to measure. This is a big advantage over standardized scoring techniques that usually do not follow the intricacies of the local bank. The scoring is also objective. The data speaks and there is no human judgment involved. Moreover, the system is self-learning. As the data changes, so will the behavior of the model. In our previous video on expert scoring, we explained how to use a score in the decision-making process. Logistic regression is not so easy to understand. However, working together in Excel and trying to do the calculations will certainly help. At least you should have a good idea how regression analysis works. We end with listing the advantages of logistic regression credit scoring. Easy to implement without sophisticated IT systems. Based on the financial institution's own data and is hence a bespoke model. Self-learning. Objective, the data speaks. Provides a clear numerical outcome for decision making. Can be combined with other scoring techniques or human decision making. Can be integrated in a workflow approach for loan requests. Good luck.